Hey, what's going on, crypto people? It is the Crypto Siege with another day in the light, in the crazy light that it's a digital asset space. Good afternoon. It's 1:18 officially Central Time. Happy Wednesday. Yes, Wednesday. I know it is Wednesday because I'm going to hang out with my baby girl. She's off for school, cosmetology school. So I'm going to hang out with her for a few days. That's going to be really, really, really cool. So guys, listen. Interesting stuff going on with the market. Again, the market is doing what the market does. Some interesting stuff. Some Celsius news on some claims. I'm going to go over that. But most importantly, you know, we got to go over the big discussion. We got to go over the big topic of the day. We heard yesterday that Judge Torres ruled in favor of Ripple to allow the amicus briefs from iRemit and the TapJet, something like that. We're going to go over that as well. Eleanor Tourette is in the news with some very, very interesting stuff I want to share with you guys. OFAC is getting sued. We're going to cover that. They're getting sued. OFAC, you know, the same OFAC that did the thing with Tornado Cash. Yeah. Lawsuit. So I'm going to cover that. Some interesting, very, very interesting stuff there, guys. So in any case, listen, this is your XRP Ripple daily news. And around 0 to 10 minutes. Let's do it. So look, the total cryptocurrency market cap is at $958 billion. Not a great number when you consider that at one time it was over $3 trillion. The Bitcoin dominance is at 38.2%. Again, just not a great number if you're looking for a bull run alt season type. Bitcoin is trading at $19,105. Again, Ethereum is trading at $1,295. Again, an XRP is trading at 48.9 cents. Again, lots of double figure reds on the 7 day. HBAR, look at Hedera Hashgraph, 12% up on a 7 day. Shout out to Hedera Hashgraph and that community out there. The Huobi token is up 59%. It must have been that acquisition by I think it was a VC firm, Capital Something, that bought up the Huobi exchange. Maybe that's it. Why it's pumping so much. Interesting to say the least. There it is, guys. Listen, the market, again, is just doing what the market does. Interesting stuff. So where do I want to start? Let's start with this. I find this to be very, very, very fascinating. Cody Carbone. From the Digital Chamber, Vice President of Policy, Digital Chamber, announced a big thing. We've heard it, right? Congrats to Digital Chamber member BNY Mellon for the news that they're officially entering the crypto custody space. He says it's a game changer. So the Wall Street Journal put this out yesterday. Bank of New York Mellon is becoming the first large U.S. bank to safeguard digital assets alongside traditional investments on the same platform. It's some interesting stuff, right? CBN1 Mellon, everyone's just like, yay, congrats. And it is awesome in a lot of ways, right? It's awesome in a lot of ways. Perianne Boring, founder of Digital Chamber. Founder, interesting. This is a huge development, says Perianne. Many years in the making. Getting the bank regulators comfortable with crypto has been a significant undertaking. Banks will serve as an important component to the mass adoption of Bitcoin and crypto. Now, for me, it's a little funny because, you know, there was one time when Perianne and her, you know, and her buddies were, banks are bad, down with the banks, we don't need the banks. You remember that back in the BTC Maxi days? But anyway, that's interesting, to say the least, to see them coming around to the reality of the situation. And here's another terrible reality of the situation. Shout out to Magoo PhD for sharing this. This is very, very interesting. You know, I've covered this on the channel numerous times about Caitlin Long and how Caitlin Long had sued the Federal Reserve. And the reason why she had sued them is she felt like they were stonewalling, you know, they're just giving them a runaround, referencing what she was trying to do with her bank, becoming regulatory, you know, getting regulatory compliant, getting all necessary licenses, block, checking all the boxes to do her own thing with her bank, right? That lawsuit. And we had got the word also that a lot of these banks are trying to do what they need to do, but the quote unquote slant SEC won't allow the FINRA to give these banks, give these banks, new players in the space, an opportunity to participate in the new financial system. I want you to really take a listen to what Caitlin Long says here, because I've said this once, I've said this a thousand times, and people still want to argue with me about this. And that is a real war going on, a real war, not the BTC and XRP and Ethereum war. The real war is a fight for you and I to stop walking away from their liquidity pools, and for us to stop having the ability to choose our own money and the monetary policy that comes along with it. And if any other newcomer comes in and acknowledges the fact that you have a right to choose your money, where you want to store it, how you want to hold it, and have it be your choice to do so, they're going to try to squash that, right? Old money is going to try to squash that. Take a listen to this. This is huge.
And it gets to the question of whether crypto truly is risky within the traditional banking system and the connectivity, because there was a major announcement this morning, which is that Bank of New York Mellon, which is, I believe, the largest bank in the United States by assets, has officially now entered Bitcoin custody. And the interesting question that is raised by that is that they are a bank holding company that is regulated by the supervised by the Federal Reserve. My company, as you know, has a lawsuit against the Federal Reserve, and I am about to make some news. You will see a filing from my company in that lawsuit pertaining to the announcement this morning, because the Federal Reserve filed filings last week talking about the risk to the financial system from crypto. And then today, a Federal Reserve supervised bank holding company enters crypto. We've been waiting for 2.5 years to do that. And look what the Fed actually said last week versus what it did today.
No one's ever accused DC FinTech Week of not over having too many shy people.
Right. So, and then saying is, right, look, we're 2.5 years ahead of BNY in our filing for the same thing that BNY Mellon just got the blessing from the Federal Reserve to do. This is the classic example of old money not wanting you or I to win. A classic example. And so when I hear people say, oh, they're not paying attention to you or I, oh, they're not really. No, I mean, the SEC, I mean, they just want some regulations. They just want, you know, what they don't want is for you and I to win in this new asset class that is called the digital asset space. And Caitlin Long is an average Jane, just like you and I may be an average Joe, average Jane, just an average person trying to participate in the space. And old money put a nix on that. Old money put a nix on that. And it is a sad thing to see, but that is the truth, and that is the war that we all are dealing with and having to face with. Let's never forget this. So let me share this OFAC thing, because I shared this with you. I mentioned this early in the intro. Jerry Brito, who is he has something to do with CoinCenter, but I'll show it here. Executive director of CoinCenter, the DC-based crypto think tank and board member of OpenCryptoOrg.org. Today, CoinCenter filed suit in federal district court against OFAC, challenging its authority to sanction Tornado Cash immutable smart contracts. Not only are we fighting for privacy rights, but if this precedent is allowed to stand, OFAC could add entire protocols like Bitcoin or Ethereum to the sanctions list in the future, thus immediately banning them without any public process whatsoever. This can't go unchallenged. We intend to win this challenge, even if it's necessary to go to the Supreme Court, and we'll keep you posted as the case unfolds. You can read more about our suit here. Not so fast, OFAC, right? And again, this is it's important to stand up for this because, again, the real war is about you and I walking away from their liquidity pool and saying we don't want to participate in no activity fees on our bank accounts. We don't want to participate and you have to pay a fee to even have a bank account. We don't want to participate in overdraft fees at an outrageous rate where you deposit money and then 5 hours later a transaction comes through, but they allow the transaction to go through before your deposited money goes through and they charge you a fee. No longer do we want to participate in a system where the likes of JP Morgan and Jamie Dimon make billions of dollars a quarter in profit. And profit a quarter. And the vast, vast majority of that is because of fees. Even in a cross-border space where they're charging the other 9,998 banks to participate in that system. Yeah, we no longer want to participate in that. And that's where the war is. That's where the fight is. They want to hold us back. That's the fight. Make no mistake about it. That's why it drives me crazy with the XRP maxis who think that the fight is against Bitcoin and Ethereum. But it's not. It's not. All right, guys. This is going to wrap up my XRP Ripple Daily News in 0 to 10 minutes. I hope it has been of value to you. If it has, do me a favor. Would you hit that like button and subscribe to the channel if you're enjoying the hangout? Win a Matt Rush to get to 10,000 just subs and see if we can't break this curse of YouTube subscribers going up to 7,640 and going back down to less than 7,600 and then going back up to 7,640 and then going back down. Hopefully we can break it. But in any case, I'm going to continue to turn on the microphone, flip up this laptop and hopefully add value to your lives. I'm going to end this video, guys, like I do all of my videos and remind you guys of this.
Old money doesn't want you to win. They don't want us to win. They would rather that we remain a cog in their perpetual wheel of trading our time for dollars. They don't want us to play in the same playground that they play in, where we allow our money to work for us. This is our chance to win, guys. The digital asset space is our chance to win. We are in the midst of the greatest transfer of wealth in the history of man. Are you participating, or are you standing on the sidelines? Here's what I do know, that the battle for you has already been fought, and the victory is yours. Go get it.